Hallelujah.
Amen.
Lion of Judah, Lion of Judah, King of Zion, reign, Jesus, reign. Hallelujah. If someone can help me there to read in Jesus' mighty name.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It reads as follows. And he said to them, follow me, and I will make you fishers of men.
Hallelujah.
Master, we toiled all night and took nothing, but at your word, I will let down the nets. And when they had done this, they enclosed a large number of fish, and their nets were breaking. They signaled to their partners in the other boat to come and help them, and they came and filled with the boats, so that they began to sink. But when Simon Peter saw it, he fell down at Jesus' knees, saying, depart from me, for I am a sinful man, O Lord. Verse 10. And so also were James and John, sons of Zebedee, who were partners with Simon. And Jesus said to Simon, do not be afraid. From now on you will be catching men.
Amen.
Amen.
In the meantime, turn to Isaiah chapter 35, verse 8-9. Don't read for Isaiah. Don't read good news. Don't read NIV. You can read the message and the Living Bible and New King James Version. So for Isaiah 35.
Jeremiah 31, verse 21. It reads as follows. Set up road markers for yourselves. Make yourself guideposts. Consider well the highway, the road by which you went. Return, O virgin Israel. Return to these your cities.
Isaiah 35, verse.
Verse 8 to 9.
Verse 8 says, a highway shall be there, and a road, and it shall be called the highway of holiness. The unclean shall not pass over it, but it shall be for others. Whoever walks the road, although a fool, shall not go astray.
John 21, verse 15. It reads as follows. When they had finished breakfast, Jesus said to Simon Peter, Simon, son of John, do you love me more than these? Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Shall we close our eyes? Moya wengwele, moya sumandla, kulunkulu ophilayo. Jehova wasemandulo libola bakholwayo Thixo wethu namandla, we are here gathered in this place moya wengcwele just for your own purpose kulunkulu namandla onke just for your gospel oh Lord to be advanced moya onamandla in this earth moya wengcwele we thank you oh Lord for your presence that are with us Thixo wethu namandla onke the Shekinah glory of the Lord Bow on Amanda, okay. It said, oh Lord, in a way that you are Jehovah Shammah. Bow on Amanda, that is the Lord is with us. We thank you, oh Lord, Tikon Amanda, okay, for being with us. So, Manda, this is your word. Bow on, speak your word, oh Lord. Eka menili ayesu. Wasen Nazareth, Lord, we pray, Kulungulo Namanda, okay. Bow on, and Kosiami, Tikon Amanda, okay. Sisengela phansi yonke into elokuphakamisa Thixo wethu namandla onke kunobukhulu bukaThixo bawo ingcwele siphakama Thixo wethu phakama and let your will be done uNkulunkulu ingcwele amongst us egameni likaYesu waseNazaretha in Jesus mighty name amen hallelujah I just want the hallelujah to point out some few things hallelujah in those scriptures that we have read hallelujah we are not preaching, hallelujah, our understanding. We are not preaching, hallelujah, our knowledge. We are not preaching the way we can explain the Bible, hallelujah. But what we are preaching, hallelujah, is the gospel. What we are preaching is the mystery, hallelujah. We are preaching the revelation, hallelujah, from the mystery, hallelujah. The Bible, hallelujah, itself is a mystery. Hallelujah, hallelujah. The mystery which is Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, that is in the Bible. Hallelujah. So we are preaching, in other words, hallelujah, a person, a living person, hallelujah,
oh, yeah, so
which is Jesus Christ, hallelujah.
Yeah,
we are preaching, hallelujah, a breathing person, hallelujah, the person that has feelings like you, hallelujah, which is Jesus Christ, hallelujah,
amen.
And him alone, hallelujah.
Amen.
We are not preaching our understanding.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want to note some few things here, hallelujah. I don't want, hallelujah, to talk, hallelujah, the things of my God, hallelujah, or the things of my understanding, hallelujah, but I'm going to talk, hallelujah, what the Holy Ghost, hallelujah, has laid, hallelujah, in my spirit, hallelujah, to deliver, hallelujah, in this
Jesus.
Afternoon, amen,
Banuele.
Amen. Looking at our theme, hallelujah, our theme says, hallelujah, follow me, hallelujah, and I will make you fishers of men. Hallelujah. And the Holy Ghost added, hallelujah, this theme. And he says that at the same time, hallelujah, I am declaring or I am ordering, hallelujah, a comeback, hallelujah, into the highway of the Lord.
Amen.
Follow me. I will make you fishers of men. At the same time, I'm declaring and ordering, hallelujah, a comeback into the highway of the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You know where we are reading, hallelujah. It is the first ministry, hallelujah, of Jesus Christ, hallelujah. He was in a period, hallelujah, of post-temptation, hallelujah. He was in a period, hallelujah, of post-training, hallelujah. For you to start a ministry, hallelujah, you must start somewhere. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You must be attacked. You must be trained. You must be tempted.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So he was from that period. So he says, come or follow me. I will make you fishers of men. Hallelujah. This is a crucial part. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ is inviting, hallelujah, his disciples, hallelujah. He is calling them, because without a call, hallelujah, they shouldn't have become a fishers of men. He has to call them first, so that they must come, hallelujah, to be, so that they might become, hallelujah, a fishers of men. There should be a calling first, hallelujah. And guess what? He is here today calling you, hallelujah,
Amen,
to be a fisher of men.
Amen.
Because you can't be a fisher of men without being called. You must be called, you must hear a calling first, so that you can become to qualify, hallelujah,
Amen,
to be a fisher of men.
Jesus.
He said, follow me. And then the other thing, Holy Ghost says that without the response of the disciples, that the calling was made, hallelujah, yes, then without their response, there is no way that they can become, hallelujah,
yeah,
a fishers of men.
Yeah.
Jesus.
They have to respond to the call.
Yes.
That when he says, hallelujah, I will make you fishers of men, they were ought to respond that, Lord, we will follow.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the Spirit revealed that in order for them to follow, they have to make, hallelujah, a committed agreement.
Oh, yes.
Or a determined agreement. Hallelujah. A committed agreement, hallelujah, means that even if no one is following, but I have decided to follow.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. That is a committed agreement, hallelujah. They have to commit themselves, hallelujah, in following Jesus. Hallelujah. Without a commitment, it was not, hallelujah, an empty, hallelujah, a following, or it was not a shallow, hallelujah, following, but there was a deep, hallelujah, commitment, hallelujah, into the following.
Amen.
They have to commit themselves.
Amen.
They have to commit, each and every one of them, they have to commit. That me, myself, I will follow.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Amen. Without a commitment, there is no way that you can follow him.
Yeah.
Amen.
So you must respond and commit yourself. The commitment is not depending to Jesus, but the commitment, it lies to them. It's,
yeah,
yours, it's your duty to commit yourself to Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And guess what? When they start to make that commitment and say that we will follow,
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
That Bible of Mamu, it says immediately,
Jesus,
they left their nets.
Yes.
Immediately. Hallelujah.
Yes.
That means, hallelujah,
yes,
when you make this agreement,
yes,
immediately, yes, there must be something that drops off.
Yes.
Talking about your boyfriend, I am not talking about your girlfriend, because that can take some time.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
To drop off.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Amen. But I am talking about something that you value.
Yes.
Because,
yes,
you know, Peter, it was his lifestyle.
Jesus.
He was valuing the, yes, nets.
Yes.
He was valuing, hallelujah,
yes,
the boat.
Yes.
But when he made that commitment,
yes,
he has to live, to let, hallelujah, those be immediate.
Yes.
Hallelujah. So when you make this commitment, the friends has to be clapped on.
Hey,
Jesus.
Amen.
They will say, no, man. There is a difference in your life. What has happened to you?
Amen.
And there must be some drop offs.
Oh, yes.
As you go along, there must be some drop offs.
Jesus.
Because they left it. Amen. Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Let me take you to the book of John. Maybe it will be clear to you. You know Jesus, when he was inviting, hallelujah,
Jesus,
a Samaritan woman, hallelujah,
yes,
into the pool, hallelujah.
Yes.
He said, give me some water to drink, hallelujah. And then he, by saying this, he was, hallelujah, inviting.
Yes.
When she responded to the invite,
yes,
there were some crumbles,
yes,
immediately, because she left her water tap,
yes,
and ran,
yes,
hallelujah, into the street.
Yes.
That, hallelujah, I met a man that has told me,
yes,
this I ever touched.
Yes.
There must be some crumbles.
Yes.
Salwane,
yes,
are you committed to the calling? There must be some drop offs immediately.
Jesus.
Amen.
They left their net.
Jesus.
And follow him.
Amen.
You know, Zebedee, when he responded to the call, he left his father immediately.
Yes.
Because he was valuing his father. There must be some drop of those things that you value.
Yes.
They must drop off immediately.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then he said, I will make you. There was a calling.
Response.
A committed agreement, your response.
Yeah.
Now, it's consecutive, it's a procedure, you see.
Mm-hmm.
Now, he said, now that you have responded to my call, I will make you.
Mm-hmm.
He can't make you if you didn't respond.
Yeah. Yes.
You must respond first.
Amen.
And tell him that I commit.
Yeah.
Then he said, now that you are mine, hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah, that I've taken almost all the grounds of your life. Now I will make you,
amen,
to be a fisher
of
men.
Yes. Amen.
In other words, he says that I will plant your feet into the highway,
yes,
of the Lord. Into the divine highway. Hallelujah. So here there is an implantation of feet into the divine highway of the Lord.
Yes.
The main part, hallelujah, it's an implantation,
yes,
into the divine highway. The song says that he planted my feet into the highway of the Lord. So in order your feet to be planted into the highway of the Lord, he must make you.
Yes.
You are not planting yourself, but he, Jesus, must plant you, must set your feet into the highway of the Lord.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I am going somewhere with this highway thing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, the last part of this theme, it says that at the same time, he is ordering and he is declaring, hallelujah, a comeback into the highway of the Lord.
Amen.
The comeback is not made, hallelujah,
Jesus,
to someone who is already in the highway.
Yeah.
Okay.
The comeback is made to those people that has
left, yeah,
go astray into the highway.
Amen.
Then he said, come, this is the highway,
Jesus,
of the Lord. And then the comeback is made to those people. There are two types of people. Is made to those people, hallelujah, that were created,
Jesus,
to be in the highway of the Lord, but they are not in that highway yet.
Okay.
They were created to be in the highway, but they are not there yet.
Jesus.
So he is ordering a comeback.
Okay.
Because they were created to be in the highway.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then he said,
He said, I will make you fishers of men. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then, I like there. Okay, let me start here. When he is calling you, ne, he is looking at your lifestyle.
Yeah.
He looks at what you like and you are passionate about. The speaker that was preaching here said that Peter was preaching, was fishing even naked.
Yeah.
That means he was passionate about this thing.
Mm.
Hallelujah. Jesus. So he looked at the thing that you are passionate of. He looked at the thing that you are competent to do.
Yes.
At your lifestyle that you are competent to do.
Yeah.
Because he cannot introduce something new to them. When they know what to say to them, that come, I will make you, hallelujah,
Jesus,
to be the healers of people, to be there to treat the diseases.
Amen.
Because their passion was not there. They were going to be confused now. What this man is, what is talking, what is he talking about?
Jesus.
But in order for them, hallelujah, to follow him, he must yield their lifestyle.
Jesus.
And I will make you fishers of men. He is looking at your lifestyle in a positive eye.
Okay.
He looks in your lifestyle in a positive attitude.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. He doesn't criticize your lifestyle.
Okay.
He wants to use your lifestyle. Hallelujah. Only for his kingdom.
Oh, yes. Amen.
When you might not see that thing, because it was meaningless to the disciples that I will make you fishers of men.
Okay.
But he was looking beyond their scope of practice.
Okay.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And looking at the Samaritan woman,
Jesus,
he is not introducing something new. He says, bring your husband.
Yes.
Because he knows that he is
Jesus.
He said, Daddy, bring your husband. And then he said, I don't have a husband.
Jesus.
Then he said, yes, you are through by saying that. Because even the man that you have is not your husband.
Yes.
Because you have been married to 5 men. Hallelujah.
Wow.
This lady is competent to attract men.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. When the man, hallelujah, is seeing her, hallelujah. Let me use this lifestyle.
Jesus.
Let me use this lifestyle for my kingdom.
Amen.
Then she ran into the location.
Jesus.
And then she, she proclaimed the gospel.
Amen.
Guess what? Thousands of men.
Hey.
Not women.
Hey.
Thousands of men. Because she was competent to attract men. Into her agenda.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Many men were attracted into the kingdom of the Lord.
Jesus
wants to use your lifestyle.
Oh, yes.
Just let him, hallelujah, to step in into your lifestyle. Then he will turn it upside down.
Oh, yes.
The lifestyle of that woman, hallelujah, was turned upside down. Because she was used, hallelujah, to attract men, hallelujah, for romantic purposes.
Yes.
But at this point around, he is attracting men for the kingdom.
Jesus.
Amen.
There is something genuine now. There is something divine in this attraction.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then let's go to Luke chapter 5. Then Luke chapter 5 says that Peter is crying there. Jesus said that, do not cry. From now, you will catch men. And then I like, hallelujah, when Jesus is speaking this, at the same time, he is like a bit of dipping him, that how many men you will catch.
Okay.
He is dipping him in Luke chapter 5. Because
when the fishes were fished, the net was about to break.
Yes.
And then the net, they brought the net into the boat. The boat was about to sink.
Yeah.
Because Jesus was teaching him that how many men will be saved, will be cashed through you.
Amen.
And then he showed him that I am not calling you for an ordinary things.
Yeah.
I'm calling you for a high goal, for an extraordinary things.
Amen.
Because it was an extraordinary things for the fishes to be cast and make a boat to sink.
Jesus.
It was an ordinary things. We are called, when he calls you for greater things.
Oh, yes.
Not an ordinary thing.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then guess what? Peter, when they were preaching now to the book of Acts, in the first church, hallelujah,
Jesus,
there were 3,000 men that were saved in that night. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That 3,000 men was the fulfillment of that example of fish,
yes,
that were making the boat to sink.
Yes.
3,000 men were being saved without ladies and children.
Okay.
Only 3,000 men. That means we are called for greater things.
Yes. Amen. Amen.
If you are struggling with boyfriends, we are not saying that stop loving your boyfriends. Continue to love them.
Yes.
But let Jesus to step into this agenda.
Amen.
Of loving your boyfriends.
Hello. Amen.
Let him. It is not our part to say stop loving your boyfriend, but let Jesus to step into this lifestyle of loving boyfriends.
Yeah.
Into this lifestyle.
Amen.
Of loving girlfriends.
Amen.
Guess what?
Amen.
Many evangelists,
yo,
that were used to be the slaves, hallelujah, of loving women, and now attracting many women
to the kingdom. Oh, yes,
hallelujah.
Amen.
The lady that was struggling, hallelujah, with many boyfriends, now he is attracting many men into the kingdom.
Amen.
Of the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. But just allow him to
step in. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
If you are struggling, hallelujah, to love other girls,
okay,
lesbian, think.
Okay. Okay.
Allow him to step into that agenda.
Oh,
and he will make it to ten upside down.
Amen. Amen.
The agenda now, it will be turned upside down.
Yes.
The feelings, hallelujah,
yes,
of loving other girls will be turned upside down.
Amen.
Are you a gay? Hallelujah.
Oh.
Are you struggling?
Oh.
Hallelujah, with this gay thing.
Yes, yeah.
We are not saying stop to being a gay.
Allow God.
Let him to stop.
Oh, yes.
Things will never be the same.
Again.
If you let him to step in into that agenda,
yes,
things will never be the same.
Yes.
He will turn that agenda
upside down. Amen.
That lifestyle will be turned.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm about now to finish. Hallelujah. Mama. Hear my message. Hallelujah. And then the other thing. Jesus said that I am not calling you just to pave the way by yourself. Can someone help me to read that message? That message. I said that someone must Google. I want to, hallelujah, to show you something there in the Living Bible. Those that have Bibles, please, hallelujah, please, 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 cook for me, hallelujah.